5 seconds to go. Start. The respondent university in determining his superannuation pension considered 33 years, 7 months and 4 days as the qualifying period of service. No argument has been advanced on behalf of the respondents as to the manner in which the case of the appellant is different from that of Dr. P. Leela Krishnan and on what basis the benefit of Rule 25A was granted to Dr. P. Leela Krishnan but was withheld in relation to the appellant. We find that the appellant and Dr. P. Leela Krishnan were in fact similarly situated. Both these individuals were appointed as teaching faculty at the respondent university after practicing as advocates in various courts of Kerala. They were both appointed before the proviso to Rule 25A came into effect, that is, before 12th February 1985, and retired after the said proviso came into force. In the circumstances, we find no valid ground to sustain the application of the proviso in relation to the appellant, thereby denying the benefit of Rule 25A when the same was not applied in the case of Dr. P. Leela Krishnan, thereby allowing the benefit of Rule 25A. While we accept the settled position of law that the rule applicable in matters of determination of pension is that which exists at the time of retirement, we are unable to find any legal basis in the action of the respondent university of selectively allowing the benefit of Rule 25A. The law, as recognized by this court in Devki Nandan Prasad and Sayyid Ahmed Supra, unequivocally states that the pension payable to an employee on retirement shall be determined on the rules existing at the time of retirement. However, the law does not allow the employer to apply the rules differently in relation to persons who are similarly situated. Therefore, we are of the view that if the respondent university sought to deny the benefit of Rule 25A in light of the proviso which was subsequently inserted, thereby limiting the benefit of the rule, it ought to have done so uniformly. The proviso could have been made applicable in relation to all employees who retired from service of the respondent university following the introduction of the proviso, that is, after 12th February 1985. However, the action of the respondent university of selectively applying the proviso to Rule 25A in relation to the appellant while not applying the said proviso in relation to similarly situated persons is arbitrary and therefore illegal. Such discrimination, which is not based on any reasonable classification, is violative of all canons of equality which are enshrined in the Constitution of India. Hence, in the instant case, the denial of the benefit under Rule 25A KSR to the appellant is arbitrary and not in accordance with law. Consequently, the appellant is entitled to receive pension having regard to his total qualifying service inclusive of the period of his service at the respondent university and the period of his practice as an advocate in various courts of Kerala. In view of the aforesaid discussion, we set aside the judgment of the division bench as well as that of the learned single judge of the High Court dated 29th August 2019 and 3rd April 2006 respectively and allow the instant appeal. The respondent university is directed to calculate the amount of pension short paid to the appellant from the date of his superannuation, that is, 30th April 2007 till date and disburse such amount together with interest at the rate of 5% per annum till date of payment in favor of the appellant within a period of 2 months from the date of receipt of a copy of this judgment. It is needless to observe that such calculation shall be carried out after considering the period of practice of the appellant as an advocate at the bar and the service rendered at the respondent university. Parties to bear their respective costs. Stop.